Hey everybody, it's Eden, Tigger6121. It is Friday, May 7th, and I know I've been away for about 2 weeks, but I'm back. I hope you all watched my banana challenge from Amber and Jawoosh. I did do that. That would be the video before this, so if you haven't seen it, check it out. Lots of fun. I kind of took a 2 week hiatus, not that I was going crazy, eating crazy or anything. I've been eating pretty good. I have been working out about 5 out of 7 days a week, which is awesome. I'm actually taking a rest day today. It's Friday. We have 17 days of school left. Yeah, it's been crazy. Today, was Teacher Appreciation Week. For next year, everyone who sends gifts to their kids' teachers, please don't send us food. We don't need it. I got 2 Hershey's bars in my mailbox, chocolate-covered pretzels, Jimmy John's gift cards, which aren't the worst thing M&M's, and then all week we had stuff from our PTO. So one day there was bagels and donuts. One day there was coffee cake, really good coffee cake too. And today there was ice cream sundaes for lunch. I have to say that I did partake in some things. Tracking my calories all the way. I've gone back to using the Lose It program on my iPhone. I've been doing the Weight Watchers points and I don't know, I just kind of got bored with it. So I had a 3-month subscription. I might go back and try it a little more before I let the subscription run out for the Weight Watchers online. But just, I don't know, I'm not overly thrilled with it. And since I have to pay for it and Lose It is free, I think Lose It. So what else has been going on? Let's see. I love this Leslie Sansone walking DVDs. You've seen me talk about those before. And I found out that there are live classes you can take with walk leaders that have trained with Leslie. I finally found one in my area, which I'm very excited about. It starts June 7th. So I'm totally going to go to that. I've got some other family members recruited to check that out with me, so I can't wait for that. And I'm going to insert my way in right here. My weigh-in for today was 130.4. My last weigh-in, I believe, was 134.8, so that's a loss of 4.4 pounds over the last 2 weeks, which is really awesome. I'm excited about that. I think I've done better with getting all my water in and obviously upping the exercise. Trying to be cognizant of my eating habits, at least the best I can anyway, without sacrificing what I want. Let's see. I have something from Leslie Sansone's book, The Walk Away Book, which I know is an old book, but I wanted to read this little bit. I could devote an entire chapter to the pain we all inflict on ourselves through destructive thinking patterns. There are a million varieties about which I'm sure you know plenty, but they all come down to the same issue, not existing in the here and now. If you can truly focus on the present moment, your choices become incredibly easy. If exercise is the issue, the question becomes, will I be better off if I walk today, or whatever exercise you're doing? The answer is yes. The only way this gets complicated is when your mind starts bringing the past and future into it. Then the dangerous mind games start. See how many of these you recognize. What's the point? I'll only lose a quarter of a pound or so. I skipped yesterday, so even if I exercise today, I won't be caught up to where I should be. It's hopeless. I blew it. If I walk twice tomorrow, I can skip today. I've tried 10 diets. None of them has worked. What makes me think this will be any different? When I've lost 100 pounds, I'll look good. My parents were fat, and I was meant to be too. It doesn't matter what I try. I could walk from here to Timbuktu, and I still won't look like her. If I had started this a year ago, I'd really be showing progress by now. These thoughts, and many like them, lure you into the realm of daydreaming. They trick you into ignoring the one reality, that anything you do happens one step at a time, and you start from today. that much is obvious. Less obvious is how fast negative thoughts can crackle through your brain. Once these patterns get established, and in many of us they were established in childhood, without even being conscious of it, we go from, I wish I was better at this, to I give up. We're not even aware of it at all. All we know is that at the first time of struggle, our whole world seems hopeless. If you suspect negative thinking patterns hold you back in life, do some reverse detective work to find out. When you're hit with that feeling of hopelessness, self-criticism, or depression, ask yourself where that feeling came from. Track your thoughts backward over the past few minutes. See if you can remember what led to what. With practice, you may uncover some dysfunctional reasoning. Hiding out in your very own brain and hijacking it. If you can't ferret out your thought patterns on your own, therapists can help tremendously. I don't think that's necessary, though. Your other alternative is not to worry about the negative thoughts, but to ignore them and keep yourself strongly focused on the here and now. All you have is today. What can you do to make the most out of it? And you know, I've been thinking about this a lot lately since I read it, and that's what leads me to not exercise and not eat right. Well, I already messed up with my eating today, so screw it. I might as well eat whatever I want for the rest of the day. I'm too tired to exercise today, so I'll just exercise tomorrow. I haven't exercised at all this week. I'll start over again soon. A lot of you, your videos that I've been watching in the past couple weeks have been talking about this, so I wanted to read that little bit for you. It's really inspired me this week to make better choices, and even when I do, I'm not going to say mess up, because I chose to have an ice cream sundae today. But then, okay, I'm not going to have a huge dinner either. So I'm trying to find balance in having what I want and getting what I want. Today's the day. Can't wait. To focus on today and take things one step at a time. That's all you can do. You don't have to count calories, or whatever you want to do, but pay attention to what you are choosing to do and make the right choices. The last thing I wanted to talk about is, Biggest Loser 30-Day Jumpstart Workout. I told you there would be more DVD giveaways coming, and I am giving this DVD away. To win this DVD this time, I would love to have a video response telling us what negative thinking patterns you have overcome in the past day, the past week, the past hour, whatever, and what you're doing to be more positive about yourself, regardless of what mistakes or slip-ups you made. How are you going to reverse them